Good morning to everyone. So in this video lecture, we are trying to see how the dynamic particles are going to have a relation of displacement, velocity and acceleration when they are in the motion. So in this case, the first we are using the kinematics of particles. So only we are considering only these field parameters without considering what is the cause for that motion. Right? So here is the problem which is related to the pulleys as well as the blocks. A system of two pulleys shown in figure. Find the relation connecting the displacement, velocity, acceleration of the blocks A and the B. I hope you have seen in this system we do have a two pulleys, the P as well as the Q. The two pulleys are available. At the same time, the two blocks are there, A and the B, and which is going to be connected by a rope which is starting from A. It's winding the pulley P and then extended here, winding the Q and going to the support, right? And here the block B is hanged from the center of the pulley B, and similarly here it is moving from the side of the pulley P, A. The block A is going to be coming from the side of the pulley P. Right? So we need to find out the displacement, velocities and accelerations of these bodies we need to calculate. So for this part, we are going to be taking. So as we know, in this case, we haven't provided any other kind of information so that it is going to be a little difficult. But we can consider some of the parameters. On that basis, we can solve it. There we can see the total length of the rope which is starting from A and moving like this. The total length, the total length of rope which is moved to the pulleys and the ropes, that is equal to L. L is going to be the total length of the rope. Similarly, only the total length is going to be constant, but here the block A is going to have some kind of variations moving in the upward direction as well as the downward direction. It means that it is going to be subjected to incremental and decremental length of the rope. But when it comes to the B, the length from the center to the B is going to be the constant. Right? And similarly, here this part also going to be subjected to the variation of that rope, and between the center P to the Q also variation is there. Can you see the P is going to be the fixed one here to the rope, and the Q is going to be the flexible. Accordingly, it will going to be more up and downward direction as per the requirement of that. So on this basis, I'm going to be trying to develop some of the dimensionals over here. Now you can see I'm going to be taking with reference to this support, because this support is going to be the fixed one. On that basis, I can find the location of block A and the location of block B and the location of the pulley P. So here I am going to be taking the distance over here, that's going to be your XA. XA is going to be the location from support to the block A, and similarly the block P is going to be fixed one. So that length I am going to be taking here, XP. XP is going to be the distance from the center of the pulley to the support. So that means I have taken this support as a reference, and similarly I'm going to be taking from the Q. The distance I'm going to be considering here is the XB. Right? This is the XB. What is the pulley displacement of the Q? And the same displacement will go to the B, because this length is going to be the constant one, right? And this is the XB. On this basis, I'm going to be writing some of the displacement relationships I'm going to be writing. So what is that one? So in this case, first I'm starting from the block A. This is going to be your XA distance is there. What is the variable length which is going to be varying from the center pulley P to the block A? The variations are going to be there in the up and downward direction, right? It means that this XA is going to be varying, that I am going to be taking XA minus XP. It means that the xa minus xp means this parameter is going to be available, xa minus xp plus, and I want to find out the center of p to the q distance. Can you see that distance is going to be existing? The total distance from the support to the pulley p, sorry, pulley q is going to be your xb, and this is the xp. If I am going to be subtracting xb minus xp so that I can get this parameter, so that I am taking xb minus xp. And similarly, we are going to be considering this length of the rope is going to be your plus xb is equal to l. L is going to be your total length of the rope is going to be constant, but here some increments as well as the decrement are going to be taking place. Those parameters I have considered. Further simplification of this one, xa minus xp minus xp minus 2xp xb xb 2xb is equal to l. If I am going to be simplification, xa plus 2xb is equal to l plus 2xp. If I am going to get, this is going to be your relations, right? If I am going to be giving an increment to the xa as well as xb, because these two are going to be the variable, but l and the xp are not the variable. So further simplification of this equation, give the increment to the block a as well as the pulley q. That's going to be del xa plus 2 into del xb, that's equal to 0, because the total length of the rope is going to be constant and the 2xp also going to be the constant from the support. So that this way I am going to be getting the relation. So further simplification, the del xb is equal to minus of del xa by 2. It means that the displacement of your block a is going to be half of the displacement of your the block b. The block b can travel half of the distance of your the block a. So this way we are going to be finding the relation. By using the same equation, I am going to be do the derivation so that I can get the velocity relationships also. So in this case, the same equation I have taken, I am differentiating with respect to time. This equation dxa by dt, because xa is the variable, plus 2 into dxb by dt, that's equal to l plus 2xp, always constant, it's not changing with respect to time. So then I will get the 0, right? From this equation, I am going to say the displacement, the rate of change of displacement with respect to time, I am going to say that's going to be your Va, right? The plus 2 into is going to be your Vb is equal to 0. Further simplification of this equation, I am going to be getting the Vb is equal to minus of Va by 2. Can you see here? The velocity of the block B is going to be half of the velocity of the block B. That too, it is moving in the opposite direction. That minus is indicating that object is going to be moving in the opposite direction. Okay, from this equation, I am going to do the derivation with respect to the time once again, so that I can get the acceleration of the block A as well as the B. So that's going to be B x A d square x square d t square plus 2 into d square xb by dt square is equal to 0. If I am going to be simplifying this equation, I am going to be getting aa plus 2 into ab equal to 0. Right? In further simplification, I am going to be getting over here simplification. The acceleration of the block b is equal to minus of a. Can you see here? The velocity of the block B, again, half of the velocity acceleration of the block A, and that too the minus. It's representing the object B is going to be moving in this direction, and the block A is going to be moving in the downward direction if I am going to be making A as the reference. This way we are going to be calculating the displacement relationship and velocity relationship as well as the acceleration relationship from this one. If you know the any one parameter of the velocity, and easily we can calculate the other parameter from this equation. So from this one, what we learned? From this one, we have identified which length of the rope is going to be variable, which length of the rope is going to be constant. On that basis, we developed the equation. In this case, XA is going to be variable, XB is going to be variable length. And can you see? And between P and the Q, length also variable. Can you see XP length is going to be constant, and here the length from the center Q to the block B is going to be constant. That's we are not going to be considering. That's the variable length whatever it is there, and we had in that displacement equation, and further we developed the displacement velocity as well as the acceleration of that component. I hope you are able to understand how to start and how to proceed with that existing parameters and how to solve that equations. Thank you.